One important message, ek writer ya fir debaters are not paid based on how much English they know, but they are valued based on their skill set and what they can achieve with their English knowledge. Same is the world of programming. Aap jitne marzi programming languages seek jao, but if you're not able to achieve something with that programming language, then you don't have any value. So that is most important. And with that being said, let's begin the video.
So dosto, wo kehte hai na, to survive in tech industry, you have to continue to try to grow, evolve, otherwise you'll be kicked out. So that's why in this video, I'll be sharing the high paid technologies I am learning in 2024 to survive in tech industry and to grow as a software engineer. So sabse pehle yaar, clarifying point, I want to tell you all ki yaar, I am someone not thinking of quitting my job because I still think that there is great scope in tech industry. I don't think ki yaar, mere liye startup nahi hai. Many people think startup is the only way to reach that $1 million mark or continue to grow. For me personally, I still think ki yaar, my favorite way of growing will be software engineering, especially in a company, because the team I am surrounded with, the feeling of importance I feel in my team is mind-blowing, and that's why I want to stay a software engineer and try to survive. Ab usse pehle main aapko batau, what are the skills I am going to try to learn in 2024? I want to share what are the skills I already have, which has reached me to point when I have like 3.5 years of software engineering experience, 2 years of internship experience, worked in 3 companies, Panasonic, NCR, Microsoft, and worked on different areas of projects, Android, iOS development. And let me tell you what are the skills I have. So, sabse pehle, I have number one, great skills with UI, whether it's Android or iOS. If you want to know the libraries, I can tell you as well. In Android, constraint layout is my favorite. In iOS, Swift UI is my favorite. I also made Valentine app in iOS, which you can check out. So I really love working on the UI. Number two is API backend. I really, really enjoy working on backend. And this is something I've already made a little bit strong. So backend may, like, let's say, if you want to give me an API, how to use it, I can quickly figure out how to send data and retrieve data in the iOS app and make a Hello World app, simple sa bana ke, then make a better UI. And this is something I have done many, many times in my previous software engineering experience as well. Number three I have is how to build an API as well. Like, just go to Microsoft Azure or AWS or Google GCP. I can just go there and quickly make API in like Linux, Ubuntu, koi bhi server ho, I can build it. And number four skill that is my favorite is I have some knowledge of databases as well. Many times you have to see customer data. So I have the ability to use, let's say SQL, SQL, keh sakte ho SQL, or let's say Kusto. I have the ability to navigate in databases, see where customer data is null, not have problems. So these are the four areas of expertise I have, and I want to build up to a level that I am more important in my team, and I'm there to not just survive, but to thrive. Okay, so ab baat karte hain, what are the skills I am going to learn? So sabse pehle, number one skill that I am going to improve upon is my backend server side skills. So thoda sa aapko background deta hu. In server, there are 3 ways to connect to an API. Number one is software as a service. Like bana bana software aap use karo. Let's say you go to Play Store, download an app, that's software as a service. Number two is platform as a service. So let's say software is ki bana bana ghar le rahe ho. Platform as a service, like ki platform bana hai, uspe aap ghar apna daloge. Good example could be AWS Lambda function. Uspe aap Python file dalo, it will be hosted and you can use that server. You don't need to create a virtual machine on your own. Number three is infrastructure as a service, where you have to do everything on your own. You go there, create a virtual machine and create an infrastructure, knee se, like from the ground up, build a house. So ye teen cheeze clarify karne ke baad, I want to tell you that I am currently building up on my backend API skills, because in number three, infrastructure as a service, even though I have taught you in our Android cohort already, I am building upon specific things which is needed to host a server. Docker sabko pata hai. I already know Docker very well, which I have taught as well in my Android batch. Ab Docker ke upar, I am learning something called Podman. So Podman is very similar to Docker, but I am replacing all the places where I had used Docker I'm using Podman instead. Podman is more secure and it has a better future according to me as compared to Docker. And Podman is very similar to Docker. I have even conducted sessions. Mere liye sabse badi skill kya hai? Speaking, public speaking, not just in front of you, in front of the camera on YouTube, but also company mein bhi, like to teach my skills. And you know, this way I was able to teach my Docker and Podman skills in my work environment as well. So this is my favorite and I will be continue to work on Docker, Podman. And to build this up, what I'm learning is Kubernetes. So mujhe zyada nahi pata, but I know these are like, you know, this is about having a lot of Docker containers and unhone ground up bade level pe manage karna, which I don't have much expertise. And I see that ki kafi log jo who are just front-end developers as well, they have this level of expertise because this can help them be unique in this industry and take their expertise to a level kyun kahin pe bhi ja sakte hain. So many times when tech industry happens, whether you are in startup, in a company, hota kya hai ki, let's say you are sometimes a front-end developer, you can move to back-end as well, server side as well. If you have the skills, you're ready to evolve, you're a quick learner, you can do it and you are felt, you feel more important this way. Manager bhi aapko priority deta hai. So that's why my goal is to have the highest impact in my team and in my company and for the customers as well, taki mera code bahut logon tak pahunche. Now number two, Docker Podman to ho gaya, little bit back end. Number two that I really want to try is that it's Swift UI mein. I really want to get into UI kit. So UI kit is very cool in iOS with which you can do prototyping and you can do some wireframing. Aap apne app ka design visualize kar sakte ho. I really want to learn more UI skills. Do you know why? Because I have felt many times UX designers, UI designers also do mistakes. Agar if you have the mindset of UI designer as well, little bit, bahut zyada skills ki things nahi hai, little bit visual elements, wireframing and prototyping, if you have little bit experience, you can catch a mistake of a UX developer and see ki yaar ye flow baat nahi ban rahi. I have never seen this layout, it is kind of bad. Aap galtiyan jab nikalte ho, whether it is in UI UX, don't be rude, don't take out mistakes and be rude. Try to be polite and say that things don't seem the way that I expect it to be. Because if you have expertise in multiple areas, you can have a higher level impact as compared to just one area. Number three skill that I'm working on is problem solving for bugs in a faster way. So currently my problem solving skills are pretty good. For example, humne ek project banaya tha. I helped you in open source project in Android. If you can check out this video, usme we did an open source contribution in like 30 to 40 minutes. I debugged the app and fixed a problem, added a feature to that Android app, which is completely open source. Now, that took me 40 minutes. I really want to be at a stage when I can figure out a problem faster and navigate to the core problem and solve it. So iske liye there is a lot of ways to do it. That is the number one way is practice. Aapko khud, you have to go ahead, just like in my project of Android open source, you have to go ahead, go to open source projects, see what problems they are facing and see where the solution could be. Aapko pura karne ki zarurat nahi hai. Just at least analyze the problem properly so that your problem skills are evolving. Aapko different problems आप देख रहे हो, उन्हें सॉल्व कर रहे हो, योर प्रॉब्लम सॉल्विंग एबिलिटीज विल इंप्रूव ओनली इफ यू सॉल्व मल्टीपल प्रॉब्लम्स एंड दैट्स समथिंग व्हाट आई जेन्युइनली एंजॉय एंड दैट्स व्हाई आई लॉन्च माय कोहोर्ट एज वेल बिकॉज आई फील लाइक टू टीच इज टू लर्न ट्वाइस. नाउ नेक्स्ट मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट स्किल दैट आई एम गोइंग टू लर्न इज, यू माइट थिंक यार इट इज आउट ऑफ माई एरिया ऑफ एक्सपर्टीज, मेरे आस पास भी नहीं आती, बट आई एम स्टिल गोइंग टू लर्न इज JavaScript and React Native. Why I'm learning? Because first of all, Android iOS development is evolving. There are few developers in the area of native, cross-platform development. Native to bahut hai, Android, iOS, Xcode, Android Studio, but there is strong demand of React Native and Flutter developers as well. And I really want to touch that on. Kyunki kafi baar mere sath hua hai in my company that I have been asked to work on a web project as well. And I see bunch of JavaScript code and bunch of NPM, Node, Express, to thoda sa dar lagta hai. Now I want to remove that fear as well. Have little bit basic understanding of Mern stack as well. Even though like I don't need to, I'm very happy with Android iOS, but in order to evolve, I really want ki agar kal khuda na kare, if like opportunity for me in Android iOS is over, I should be ready to evolve as a Mern stack developer as well, JavaScript developer as well, web developer as well. So that's why I'm really brushing up on my Mern stack abilities, because usse bhi with that JavaScript React Native abilities, maybe I can use that in React Native Android, iOS as well. Currently, I still think there is more scope with native software engineering, native development in Android and iOS, but you have to be ready. So, I keep my vision 2-3 years aage rakhta hun. Because if you're not learning, currently I'm very comfortable with both. Like currently, jab aap ek cheez baar baar kar lete ho, let's say, you know, aap bhaag lete ho with a weight on your bag, then without bag, bhagna easy hota hai. Same way, like once you have coded for 12-13 hours on your project, then easier projects, like jisme chote-chote projects hai, they become easier for you. Similarly, I really want to take that load of web development as well. Next time, any project given, I'll be able to run faster with it. So I really want to challenge myself, and these are my 4-5 goals. Really want to build up on my API skills, infrastructure as a platform, Kubernetes, DevOps skills badhani hai. I really want to be at a stage ki main deploy jab code karta hun, that should be done seamlessly with one click of a button and I can see what is going on. Number two, I really want to learn more about GitHub Actions. GitHub Actions mujhe acche se aata hai, but I really want to go more into depth of CI/CD, because sometimes some things are maybe like out of my control. I want to have holistical end-to-end knowledge and sharpen on all of these skills, API, backend, UI, and especially UX development as well. So these are my goals. Tell me your goals in the comments below for 2024, and I'll see you all in the next one. Goodbye.